Okay, I'm going to make this video real quick, but we're going to do a processor swap. I got an Intel i3 2.2 in here. And if you look at my Windows Experience Index, which doesn't mean a whole lot, it rates about 6.5. That 7.6 is my solid state disk. And I just ordered, I just got in, an Intel i7 2640M, which is the fastest dual-core mobile CPU you could get as of the generation of this laptop. So it runs at 2.8 gigahertz with a turbo core up to 3.5 for single core stuff, but 2.8 is very fast. And it should technically even be faster than that quad core 1.6 I put in my Alienware. But I got my my Arctic Silver Ceramic, which I love, don't be haters. I got my rubbing alcohol, my screws. I'm gonna pull this laptop apart, and I probably won't film too much. The disassembly isn't much. I might do a video later about it, but I'm gonna take all the screws out of the bottom, pull the keyboard out, take the screws out that are underneath the keyboard. This top plastic should come off. I'm gonna do that off camera, and then maybe I'll bring it up when I actually pop the CPU in and out. So, and I'm gonna see if it makes an effect on this external GPU. I'm getting playable frame rates right now with the external GPU. But I'm wondering if this i3 is a bottleneck. So if I put the 2.8 in there, it's actually going to perform more like a Pentium desktop or maybe an i3 desktop than a mobile CPU. One thing I did want to note is that my laptop does have the latest BIOS A09 because they did add support for new CPUs. In two versions of the BIOS, so I made sure I updated to the latest one. It actually came updated to the latest one, so I know that it's not going to break the functionality of my eGPU, and I know that I at least have a BIOS that will support all of the CPUs up to this point. And actually, if you can actually buy the Vostro 3550 on their website as of when I ordered mine in 2012. And the only CPU they sell it with is the dual-core i7 now. Since it's kind of a legacy, they only offer it with the best one. So technically, it should support this one. I just wanted to show you that. I did it before I did this, so I didn't run into the same problem I did with my Acer. Okay, I took out all the screws on the bottom. I took out all the screws on this metal piece. And there were a couple screws under the little sticky tacks. And this thing just popped right off after the keyboard came off. So all I have to do is take out all these screws from the motherboard, and this guy should turn over, and I can get to the CPU that's underneath here. So, I'm gonna get to work. Well, it kind of came out like one big piece. I'm gonna flip it over here, and we have the CPU itself. Now, if it had a built-in GPU, the GPU would be right here, but it doesn't have the Radeon chipset. So it's got these two little daughter boards on it. This one right here, and then there's a daughter board right here. This one has like the wireless on it. This is the connector for the PCI Express card that makes the eGPU magic work. I'm gonna go ahead and pull this off. There's the three screws, and I think a little connector on the other side here, right there, that powers the fan. So I'm gonna disconnect that, pull that apart. I'm gonna do that off camera so I can have both hands. Okay, here it came off. There's the thermal compound, which I'll clean off. Here's the old i3 right there. And then this is like the thermal tape that sits over these voltage regulators to kind of transfer a little bit of heat from them up into the sink itself. So I'm going to go ahead and put the new CPU in and tighten everything back down and put it all back together. It's pretty uneventful, so I'm probably not going to film it unless something crazy happens. But I am going to clean this off with some rubbing alcohol, and then prep it, and then just use a little bit of Arctic Silver Ceramic. I know you guys give me a hard time about, one, the type of stuff I use, and two, how I apply it, but screw you. I've been doing this for over 15 years, never had a problem with it. And the ceramic is non-conductive, so that when I do put too much on and it squeezes out the sides, it won't blow anything up. One thing I will say is you do have to take the two hinge screws out and take the screen actually off to get the motherboard to come out. There's no fasteners under there for the motherboard, but it is on top of it. So once you take those out, it's a lot easier to get that motherboard out. Just saying. Oh, and these two screws right here, this one and this one, are for the hard drive. Do not put screws in those or you won't be able to attach your hard drive. But other than that, I think I got it back together. Okay, we're going to do a first boot. All the lights came on. Hey! No evil beeps yet. God bless SSDs. I gotta reinstall my video drivers, but that happened last time because technically I'm switching the video card. You know? And that device could either be my PCI Express. Now, yeah, it's picking up that Intel Core. There we go. Picked it up with the Intel 3000 graphics. I don't know what that other one had. I think it only had HD. It might have had 3000. I'm going to reboot it, plug it in, and we'll do the Windows test or whatever. Well, this thing running is keeping that CPU at about 67%, and it's staying at 3.29 gigahertz. So, I don't know what that means, because when you're using both cores, it's only supposed to run at 2.8. So, either it means it's not taxing it enough to heat it up, or something's not right, or it's, you know, I don't know. I wonder if I pegged it at 100% if it would drop down to 2.8, because it does idle down. When you're not doing anything, it drops down to about 900 megahertz. So, the CPU test is done. I guess the Windows Experience Index doesn't really test it to, you know, 100%. It only got up to about 68% when it peaked. I was going to see if, so right now, I mean, it's never, when I've been doing stuff, it's never dropped under 3.2 gigahertz. You know, I mean, it really wasn't hitting 100% utilization, so I don't know. We'll see. Because I think the turbo core peaks at 3.5. I was kind of waiting for this thing to finish up to see if it flashed and changed any. It says the CPU went to 7.1. And I think everything else about stayed the same. The other two were, what, 5 and 5 and 5 and something, so... You know, I'm very happy with that result. I'll see if I can throw some gaming benchmarks up here to compare them to the old numbers, too. So, I'll probably run those tomorrow and put the video up later. It's, almost 1 in the morning, so I'm going to hit the sack.